I'm Neeti Parashar. I'm a professor of physics at Purdue University Calumet. I have a doctorate in high energy physics. I do my research at Fermi National Accelerator Laboratory, which is located in Batavia, Illinois. So it's about 60 miles or so from the university. Right behind me here, you see a remote operations center, which is the computing basis for one of the experiments that I'm working on. It's called Compact Muon Solenoid. It is going to take place at the largest particle accelerator in the world now, effective September 10th, at the European Organization for Nuclear Research in Geneva, Switzerland. So you could probably see our postdoctoral fellow right in the corner there working on the pixel shift. So what that means is we built a piece of the detector here along with Purdue Calumet students, my students from undergrad physics and a graduate student from mathematics, and also a couple of engineering students. So it actually gives you a feel of the fact that this is a very, very interdisciplinary kind of work that we have. So at Fermilab, we have two very good detectors or experiments, if you will, that actually detect what happens when subatomic collisions happen. So we have a 4-mile accelerator in which we have protons going in one direction, antiprotons going in the other direction and colliding. And exactly at the two locations where they collide, we have placed two detectors. We have CDF, called the collider detector at Fermilab, and D0. Purdue Calumet is a full-time member of D0, so I lead that effort. We are funded by National Science Foundation, and my group consists of a postdoctoral research associate. We have a few students, physics undergrad students, math graduate students, and engineering students. And one of the most fascinating things we had, we made two discoveries since last summer. We discovered two particles, one of which was called the Cascade B-, and the one very recent called the Omega. The first one was very crucial because it helped us understand, advance our knowledge even further as to the nature of forces that holds these particles together, which is the actually the other aspect of what high energy physics is about. And the second one that we discovered is very special because it consists of actually two strange particles. And when we say two strange, what it actually means is two strange quarks. So that's something which we theoretically knew, but we had not found them. So that's a great advancement towards what we think will help us do even better physics at the future colliders. So this future collider that I'm talking of is actually already commenced on September 10th. We had a big ceremonial startup celebration to that, where we injected the first beam of 450 giga electron volt into a 17-mile circular accelerator, which gives you actually a sense of how huge these accelerators are, or the very large scale nature of these collaborations. Of course, not to mention these are all international collaborations. We have scientists, physicists, engineers, computing professionals from all over the world working on that. And some of the key fundamental physics questions that we would address at CERN, which is, again, as I said, the European Organization for Nuclear Research, located in Geneva. It's actually right at the border between Geneva and Switzerland. We are trying to find answers to questions such as, what is the origin of mass for some of these subatomic particles? What is dark energy? What is dark matter? What is the cosmic structure of our universe? So there are many of these fundamental basic science questions that have kind of boggled minds of scientists for years. And one of the best part in my experience at Purdue Calumet that I have seen is we have students who are sometimes not very well aware of what's going around them. The moment you tell them particle accelerator and they jump out of their seat and want to come here. And in fact, every semester I bring all my class students, whether they do research with me or not, at least twice or thrice, and I think I, as a professor, feel it's our duty to inculcate this kind of interest in our students. So I get them here, they get exposed, and if they get interested, obviously, then they tell me that they want to come and work with me, which is, I think, so great for me, because then I train them, and it's excellent for them to get this kind of scientific exposure. And we are so close to the lab that this is, I think, a privilege for me as a professor to bring my students here. This is one of the nicest things.